This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Like yours, basic?
I'm a huge sunny side up egg guy.
Fancy?
Shrimp cake benedict with guacamole, whole grain mustard, and baby arugula.
Nostalgic?
Pop rock, pop tarts.
At 10 a.m. or 10 p.m. plus brunch whenever.
They now offer it 7 days a week.
Erica Tarantell says, get out of bed for these breakfasts. Shakshuka to shake up the morning.
Tastes good.
A big winner on Yelp.
One of America's top 100 places to eat.
And sneaking into Boston from Yankee territory.
You think you got good bagels? We think ours are better.
Breakfast is next on Chronicle.
Is there any guilty pleasure that tops an awesome Sunday brunch? At Lincoln Tavern and Restaurant in South Boston, brunch is so wildly popular, they now offer it 7 days a week.
I think brunch is just super fun, lots of comfort foods, you can be really creative. It's a balance of having sweet, salty, savory, and spicy. And I think that people like to gather and drink lots of cocktails when they eat.
7 days a week.
7 days a week, exactly.
Executive Chef Nicholas Dixon and his cooking comrades love to create breakfast dishes with a seismic wow factor. Take this eye-popping dark chocolate waffle with peanut butter drizzle, or the breakfast burger with hash browns, red pepper jelly, sunny-side-up egg, and hollandaise sauce.
So these are the famous Fruity Pebble pancakes.
Yes, you heard it right. Lincoln makes pancakes with Fruity Pebble cereal and vanilla icing for the inner child in all of us.
Those are great pancakes and fruity deliciousness all in one.
Brunch fanatics know that Friday is Lincoln's test kitchen day. The chefs go crazy creating buzzworthy new dishes, showcasing them on Instagram. On this day, the test kitchen whips up an audacious smoked salmon breakfast pizza, some house-smoked brisket hash, and homemade strawberry Pop-Tarts.
So what are some of the craziest ideas you've come up with?
We've had Pop Rock Pop-Tarts. Fried quail and waffles was a big hit. We did a foie gras pecan bourbon syrup that goes over the top of them with like an Eggo-style waffle. I think it's been like 500 new dishes that we come up with over the past 2 years.
When we visited, this joint was jamming, making us wonder, does everyone have Friday off in Southie? A word to the wise, on weekends, waiting lines for brunch can form before Lincoln even opens. Curious about what Chef Dixon would order? The huevos rancheros with black beans, cojita cheese, and ranchero sauce.
That's my favorite dish because it's like super savory, it's smoky from the ranchero sauce. I'm a huge sunny side up egg guy, and to me, I could eat that like literally every weekend.
At Framingham's J&amp Diner, they pile on breakfast favorites sky high. Dishes like Oreo whoopie pie French toast, pancakes layered with bacon, Reese's peanut butter cups, and Nutella. And why settle for simple home fries when you can gussy them up?
We have our loaded home fries, which are, oh my gosh, my tongue literally comes out like a cartoon character like this every time I see it go by, because you can have it with sour cream, barbecue, or ranch, and it's our home fries in a skillet with cheddar cheese and onion, bacon, and scallions.
You'll be living large at J&amp Indeed, where the monster omelets boast 6 eggs and hollandaise sauce drizzles down like rain on the Benedicts. As for the heaping heavenly hash,
we have sweet potato hash that has grass-fed beef, sweet potato, onion, bacon, cranberry for your paleo lovers or just anyone who wants something different. Our corned beef hash we make here as well with corned beef, onion, bacon, potato. It's delicious. We have waffles now, and we top it with fresh fruit and Nutella or Reese's and have fun with that.
Beyond the insane portions, what makes this place work is teamwork, say husband and wife owners Dave and Karen Fiore.
I think that it takes a certain type of person to work here. Be able to get up in the morning and smile from the minute you get in here to the minute you leave. It's about consistency and being genuine. And I love, my kids are like mini-me's. I mean, I don't even have to, I can trust the fact that they'll be amazing with customers because it's just natural.
The whimsical decor and cheery vibe here belie last year's emotional ordeal for this extended family. After 19 years in business, a spark igniting a fire in a neighboring store burned J&amp and the entire strip mall they were in to the ground.
when we turned the corner and saw the flames coming through the post office on Route 30, it really was shocking to us. Everything about it was difficult. Even finally finding this place and getting it up and going, nothing about it was easy. I have to say thank God for my family for their support, and thank God for banks, and thank God for the customers who wanted us back.
In this new location along Route 9, the boundless desire to push the breakfast envelope remains, as does the respect and trust J&M has for their foodie followers.
You know, you're working with the public, and people are hungry in the morning, so you got cranky, they haven't had their coffee, haven't eaten in about, 15 hours, so you're dealing with that, and hopefully we can make them smile and have happy tummies when they leave.
Oh my, Oreo French toast? Mm-hmm. Woo, all right, well, when the fire destroyed J&M Diner last year, it absolutely was devastating. They lost so much, including irreplaceable photos that were hanging on the wall.
Right, but Dave and Karen said they really couldn't be happier than they are in their new space. It's much bigger than the old space. It's more modern. They now take credit cards. They have space for strollers. They're really, really happy in the new space. There's also an app they have as well. You can find out how long the lines are before you get there. So they've stepped it up quite a bit.
I'm sure those lines are long. All right, a mistake made by the chef becomes a menu's top seller.
The deep-fried corned beef hash bomb with cheddar cheese and house-made hot sauce.